This video will be covering shooting in an active environment. When we're in the box, we're generally a lot closer to the goal and to other players than we are out in the field. So we don't have as much time to wind up, so everything's a little bit tighter. In this video, we'll be going over three different aspects of that shooting in an active environment. We'll be going over hand positioning, footwork, and follow through. Our hand positioning, we always want that butt end facing our target. If we come up the field and our butt end's facing upfield, when we try to follow through, generally that shot's gonna fire wide, okay? When we come up with our butt end pointing at our target, I like to think of it like a magnet on my butt end right to that pipe. I'm ready to shoot as soon as I can get my head around. The second aspect is footwork. When I come upfield, I don't wanna take that shot off balance, running this direction, trying to shoot back this way. Again, that will cause my shot to generally fire wide. So, when I come up, my butt end's pointing at the target, I wanna get my feet underneath of me, balanced, and be able to step back right at that pipe, ready to follow through. That brings us to the follow through. The last part, we actually wanna think about ourselves as a painter with a little roller trying to paint that pipe, because we have a small goal and a big goalie. We have a very small area we can fit that ball. If we try to shoot across the side, it'll generally hit the goalie or miss. When we paint that pipe, we can fit it into that small spot. This drill will be shooting off the post. First, Riley will be sidewinding to free his hands and passing down to Zach. After that, Riley's gonna cut to the goal with his stick up and then come out and set a post. As that's happening, Zach is taking his man behind, and now he's gonna come off that post with his butt end pointing towards the goal, set his feet, take a shot, and paint the pipe. Now let's see at full speed. Shooting in an active environment is one of the most important skills you can learn as an offensive player. Next, we will be looking at cutting and finishing both in the box and on the field.